Alright guys, welcome back to TNG Game. My name is Nathaniel, and we're back playing Guardians of the Galaxy. My audio might sound a little better now, because I have a new mic. I got a Blue Yeti. It's pretty cool, actually. It should sound a lot better. Especially if I get about this close. Sounds very clear, very crisp. Very crisp. Maybe not as crisp as I hope, but we'll see. But we're back in Guardians of the Galaxy. Guardians of the Galaxy, I should say. Let's go.
Well, it isn't my favorite Assassin Sisters.
Well, that'd be a pretty rad band name.
Hey, Peter. Give me one second.
Start a band.
Sure.
Do it, Quill. Peter. Oh, man. This makes me
Thank
sad.
Thank you for talking to Nebula.
I just watched...
Not sure if this will all work out, but...
I just watched Infinity War, and now I'm sad.
What are you...
I'm just sad. If you haven't seen the movie, then don't ask. Thanks, Gammy. Lean in. God, I'm not paying attention. Oh, give her a hug. Give her a big old hug.
Ow! Hey!
What?
Oh, is that a dagger? Is it... What, you got a throwing star there? Whatever, you got something pokey on your hip. Pokey.
I do not usually hug.
Sound like Drax there.
You're a good friend, Peter.
I didn't say there was a pokey thing. Wait, I'm a good friend. Okay. So now I'm just gonna make Rocket not angry at us anymore.
Hey, Pete. I threw some mean words your way back there. I wanted to apologize.
Yay, finally.
So, yeah.
Late Sorry apology accepted. Just, we need to go.
I got worked up. No,
I'm fixing things. I'm done. Forge I'm done thing. With this nonsense.
Hey, don't even worry about it, man.
Yeah.
Best friends forever?
Best friends forever.
At least
Best friends
death.
Forever. Bring.
It's close enough.
Oh. Oh, I have excellent musical taste. Dance!
I can tell these sounds bring you supreme joy!
They do. Here is out
and
of sight.
Also such sadness. You are a very nostalgic person.
Oh my gosh, calm down.
Hey, whoa, what's
happening? I don't know what's happening.
Why are you crying? Why am I crying?
I don't know.
Oh, God.
The little box brings you so much sorrow.
Oh, God.
What is happening? Why are you crying?
I'm sorry for that. Sometimes emotions overwhelm me and reflect back onto others.
That's cool.
Yeah. I remember.
I'm cool.
I'm cool. No, he's not crying.
Okay.
Everyone on this ship is so poisoned by their feelings, overly focused on the past, not living here in the now.
Forge can change, though. It's hard to escape the past. We should focus
on the wonderful things around you.
Just focus on the future.
I think it's better to focus on the future. You know, anything can be possible tomorrow.
Anything
that is a hopeful
is
sentiment,
tomorrow, or anything can be possible.
And very naive, but sometimes you need that.
Rude. I want her to have demon eyes.
Thank you for letting me listen to your music. It made me feel better and worse at the same time. I loved it.
Thanks. Go to the shrine or check codex. I guess I'll check the codex. I haven't checked it in a while. Oh gosh. Okay, I said I was gonna read this stuff eventually, but I guess I can do it now. Okay, there's a lot of reading, so this might be a longer episode just because of that. From the way he talks about them, Hovat and Kamaria were Drax's whole world. He even named his blades after them. That's pretty cool. Thanos killing Drax's family is what transformed him into the revenge-obsessed force of destruction he is today. I gotta admit, it's hard to imagine Drax as a dad. Or a husband, for that matter. Yeah, true. Update. Now that we know the Eternity Forge can be used to bring people back from the dead, maybe that's a way to reunite Drax with his family, but is it worth the risks? I don't think so. I don't think it's worth the risk at all. Drax. Name, Drax. Known aliases, the Destroyer. Planet of origin unknown. Drax describes himself as a living weapon with the sole purpose of getting revenge on Thanos for killing his wife and child, which seems pretty accurate. He started hanging out with the Guardians when he heard that we didn't like Thanos much either, and the rest is history. His grasp of humor leaves a bit to be desired, but he's got heart. Update. I thought Drax would be happier with Thanos dead, but something seems to really be bothering him. I hope he's okay. Update. Is it just me, or has Drax been eating a lot more lately? I better keep an eye on my snacks. Does eat a lot. Earth. Last time I was on Earth, Michael Jackson's Bad was burning up the charts. It's probably only gone downhill from there, so I haven't really bothered to go back. No matter where I am, though, it'll always be home. Oh, is that... Oh, Gamora. Name Gamora, known alias is none. Planet of origin, Zinwobbery. Gamora is the best friend a guy could ask for. She calls me on my BS, she's always got my back, and she can murder, like, anyone. She's been part of the Guardians since the beginning, and it's hard to imagine a team without her. She doesn't talk about her past much, but considering her entire civilization was destroyed by a power-hungry murder psycho who made her his daughter, she's way more well-adjusted than she has any right to be. Yeah, I would say so. Update, Gamora's memory of her mission with Nebula was really painful to experience. Oddly, the memory reminded Gamora of the good times with her sister, even though Nebula totally stabbed her. Super glad I never had a sibling. That you knew about. Maybe you do have a sibling. Groot. Name Groot. Ow. Known alias is none. Planet of origin, Planet X. According to Rocket, he and Groot have been friends ever since they met on a prison ship. Not 100% sure where he came from before that. Regardless, Groot's proven himself to be an invaluable member of the Guardians countless times, and I trust him with my life. Update, note to self. Don't get him drunk. The bathroom will never be the same. Groot can get drunk? That's kind of weird. Update, Groot has a plant. A little potted plant that he carries around, apparently. That's weird, right? No, it's probably like his friend. Half-world. Rocket doesn't talk about his past much, but when he does, it's not exactly uplifting. I know it involved being experimented on, but whenever I asked about it, he changes the subject. Now he wants to use the relic, but who is he trying to bring back? Update, looks like Rocket was created in a lab on Half-World. He became close with a kind otter named Lila. He misses her terribly, but she's gone. Hala. Rocket doesn't talk about his past much, but when he does, it's not Oh, wait, what the heck? Hala. Name Hala, known alias is the Accuser? Oh, it's that girl who killed me, I'm pretty sure. As far as I can tell, Hala is a Kree warrior roaming the galaxy in her ship, the Revenant. She's crazy powerful, or possibly just crazy. And seems to be really pissed particular at me. She's after the relic that I got from Thanos, she calls it the Eternity Forge. Well, she can't have it. Dang right. Hala is running around trying to bring back the glory of the Kree Empire through any means necessary. I've already had a bad run-in with her that left me dead, but that's not going to stop me. She wants the Eternity Forge so she can bring back her Kree army, take over the galaxy, kill her enemies. All the hits. How many people are there? Nowhere. Oh, that looks crazy. Okay, located inside the head of a decapitated celestial, Nowhere is a mining colony full of some of the galaxy's shadiest people, most notably us. We have a hideout here for many reasons. Convenient spot for refueling and restocking the Milano. Is that the name of the ship? If it is, I've never known it. Great place to find military-grade weapons and weapons-grade booze. It's inside a big old head. What's not to love? That's really cool, actually. I'm not gonna lie. Lila. Name Lila. Known alias is none. Planet of origin, Half-World. Lila was a science experiment, like Rocket, which means she shared his smarts and his snark. She was a nice little otter. Even Rocket was nicer back then, too. Yeah. They spent their days plotting how to escape the scientist who had been keeping them captive. All Lila wanted to do was see the outside. Rocket would do anything to bring her back. Update. Rocket tried using the Eternity Forge to revive Lila, but it didn't work. Turns out the Forge can be empowered to do that. But that also makes it even more dangerous. Rocket doesn't care though, he just wants Lila back. Okay. Mantis, that's a new one. Known alias is none. Planet of origin, Imnios? Mantis is a bit of a puzzle, with wild bug antennae to match. She's an empath, able to sense emotions and physically linked to the Eternity Forge. Still, even she doesn't have all the answers. Most of her life has been a major timeout, trapped on Imnios for ages without any contact with the universe at large. She's clueless when it comes to dealing with others, especially the Guardians, but then again, so am I. God dang. Meredith Quill, known as his mom, planet of origin, Earth. What do I say? She was a cool single mom, tough as nails, funny, great taste in music. Mom dying is proof that the universe can really suck sometimes. Miss you, Mom. Turns out those visions of my mom were actually Mantis trying to lure me to free her. My mom really is gone. But then Mantis did say the Eternity Forge could be empowered to bring people back. It's something I need to think about. Okay, Nebula. Known affiliations, unknown. Planet of origin, unknown. Gamora's sister. Gamora doesn't talk about Nebula much, but they sound like they had a similar upbringing, i.e. violent and full of murder. Nice. Nebula is as talented as Gamora, but much angrier. I told Gamora to leave well enough alone with Nebula. What? After killing her beloved father, I think the Guardians are pretty high on her list of people to stab. Hopefully we can steer clear until she chills out. Update. Well, Nebula's on the ship now. Assassin sisters reunited. Gotta say, not loving that. We were able to get her Kree cipher implant from inside her head, which was gross, but hey, I can now read ancient Kree symbols. Yay. Update. I got to see Nebula's past firsthand today with the help of Mantis. Seeing how Thanos treated her and how much she felt for Gamora, I don't quite know what to think of her. She's certainly not that same person anymore. Update, looks like Nebula will be sticking around for a while. What could possibly go wrong with that? I don't see anything. I did not do this. I should have done this while it was happening. The Nova Corps are the closest thing the universe has to law and order, and they've been protecting the universe longer than anyone can remember. They hang out on Xander, which is nice, but a little touristy for my taste. These are the good guys, but it seems like they're always asking for us to bail them out. Maybe they are stretched a little thin, patrolling the whole universe. Anyways, we can always count on the Nova Corps to do what's right, even if that means ending up on their most wanted list. Nova Corps, okay. The Nova Corps space cops, they're responsible for keeping the galactic peace, real lawful good types. I guess they're decent enough at their job, but they sure come to the Guardians for help a lot. Rocket can't stand them, but Gamora actually has a lot of respect for what they do. God, it's already... Update, I turned Thanos' body over to the Nova Corps and collected the bounty. In the end, it felt like the right call, although I've said it before and I'll say it again. Weird group of dudes. Anyway, sounds like the space cops may have my back in the future. Could come in handy. Update, apparently Nova Corps have tangled with Rocket more than a few times. Can't say I'm really surprised. Update, well, whatever goodwill we had with the Nova Corps after giving them Thanos was shattered when we basically shot them out of the sky to capture Nebula. Maybe I wouldn't have been so quick to fire on them if they had paid me for Thanos. So yeah, Nova Corps sucks. Yeah, I would say so. Name Rocket, a known alias is None. I mean, his name's Rabbit in Infinity War. Okay, planet of origin, half-world. When I first met Rocket, I thought he was a greedy, twisted little jerk. I still think all those things, but now I also know that underneath the misanthropic attitude and bad hygiene, he's incredibly hardworking, wickedly funny, and kind of a genius. He's the Milano Whisper, and I'd never tell him to his face. But he might also be one of the greatest tacticians in the galaxy. Update, what the hell? Thanos is finally dead and now suddenly Rocket wants to leave the Guardians? On one hand, he's probably earned a break, but on the other hand, I don't know. That was weird. Update, man, it's hard to believe that Rocket ever cared about someone more than Groot. He's still upset that I saw his memory of Lila, but he's more upset that the Forge didn't bring her back. Update, now that Rocket knows that the Eternity Forge can bring Lila back, if I empower it, he's never going to let go of that idea. I'm the one who has to make that decision, though. Ugh. What a... Damn, Jesus. Oh my gosh, there's so much. So mistake. Name, Peter Quill. Star-Lord, Peter Quill, okay. Star-Lord. Earth, hero, outlaw, devilishly handsome ladies, man. I've been cruising the galaxy ever since Yondu showed up and took me off-world. I was adopted by his crew, the Ravagers, until I was old enough to strike out on my own. These days I have a crew of my own, the Guardians of the Galaxy. They're almost as awesome as I am. Update. Just checked. I'm still awesome. Thanos. Okay, so I guess that's in the movie Infinity War, that's what kind of looks different. Like, his face structure basically looks exactly the same. He kind of has the same face. But his eyes are glowing in this. In Infinity War, they're not glowing. I think that's basically the only difference I can really see. They look very, very similar, actually. But anyways, Thanos. Known alias is the Mad Titan. Planet of origin, Titan. Thanos is, without a doubt, one of the scariest guys that's ever lived. Super tough, super powerful. He's on a never-ending quest to destroy and conquer as much of the galaxy as possible, killing literally billions of people in the process. A seriously bad dude. I don't know about that. I don't know about a seriously bad dude after seeing Infinity War. I don't know. Like, he has his reasons, and they're not... I can kind of see his side. But I don't think he's dead for good. I think somehow or another we're going to... Thanos is going to come back. There's no way he's just going to be dead the whole series. That doesn't make any sense. Unless he is. I don't know. But update. At least he was until we killed him. Booyah! But seriously, I'm still sort of scared of him, even though he's dead. Update. Okay, Nebula is totally obsessed with the guy. I mean, stealing his body? Who does that? Fortunately, he is still very, very dead. I don't know. The Collector. Known. Name, Tanalir Tavon. Known alias is The Collector. Planet of origin unknown. Nowhere is full of shady people, but none of them are shadier than this guy. He has a museum that buys and sells anything of value. No idea where he gets all his money, but he's apparently got units like a beach has sand. That's a lot of units. Gamora doesn't trust him at all, but Rocket is all about that bank account. Wait, did I say Gamora? Rocket's all... I don't know what I said. I already clicked on the coin. The Kree. The Kree were a technologically advanced race of aliens that used to have one of the biggest empires in the galaxy. Think evil Romans with lasers instead of swords. These days, they've been pretty MIA. I heard a rumor that something bad happened on their homeworld, and that there aren't many of them left, but I don't know anything for sure. Update, okay, I found out a little more about the Kree. Ancient warrior race bent on conquering the universe, out to kill the Guardians, blah blah blah. Who cares, right? What makes the Kree special is how twisted they are. They are obsessed with genetic science, so they splice and dice their enemies, even on each other. These orders came from their leader, the Supreme Intelligence, a giant brain that lives on Nilar. It's gross, trust me. The Kree have had a bad run of luck, and their numbers are dwindling after generations of war. Which is fine by me. Only now Hala seems determined to bring them all back. If that happens, well, that would really suck. It sucks. Oh, thank God. The last three. Okay. The Revenant. So the Milano is ours. It looks like a bird. Hala's warship. Packed full of dead Kree and staffed by a skeleton crew. She's converted it into a creepy floating tomb. It's definitely still got some serious firepower. I wouldn't want to be on the business end of that thing. The Milano. Apparently the name of our ship. A customized M ship that I inherited from Yondu and the Ravagers. The Ravagers. Inherited. Stole, basically. The Milano is the Guardian's home among the stars. She's looking pretty gnarly right now, though. Crashing into a planet didn't do her any favors. And Yondu, last but not least. Named Yondu Udonta. Known affiliation is the Ravagers. Planet of origin, Centauri IV. Leader of the Ravagers and an old friend of Mom's. He took me in after Mom died and taught me pretty much everything I know about cruising the galaxy. Yondu is not much of a father figure, and his morals are a little gray, but he's the best I got. Haven't seen him in a while, but we're still pretty friendly. Update, Yondu agreed to help fix the Milano after Hala put a couple of new holes in it. Plus, he got to meet the Guardians for the first time. That was fun. Who could have guessed he and Rocket already knew each other? And Gamondo... Gamondo? Just loves him. The freak's Gamonda? It's like Gamora and Yon. Okay. I have messages. Okay, I got a bunch of messages. I'll read those later because that's too much.
Mantis?
Can you direct me to that magic shrine thing now?
Yeah, that was a lot.
Of course. But it is a long way, and I must concentrate completely. There can be no... There can be no distraction.
I didn't know it would do that. Oh, you have made an awe-inspiring mess.
Distractions.
I'll see what I can do.
Probably not much. We play some sick tunes. Oh, what can I? That's not a good dance move.
Wash away my troubles. Wash away
my dance note. Shut up. Just shut up your mood. Yeah.
Everyone is helpful. Everyone is kind. On the road to Shambhala. Everyone is lucky. Everyone is
so. Why is
they
so angry?
On the road,
oh, they're
their
arms. It's Nebula gonna win. I feel like Nebula's gonna win. Okay, she's not trying at all. She doesn't have a freaking like mechanical arm. It's kind of cheating. Oh, wow. What is she doing outside?
I can tell my brother.
The stars look weird. It's a long arm wrestling match. Ah, that's cheating. Can't be doing that. A rock is the winner. Come by his ear, dang.
The entrance to the shrine.
Spooky. Whoa, that's cool. Whoa. I guess we're here. I don't remember what we're doing here exactly, to be honest. I don't know.
This is it.
Yay! Another temple!
Yay! It looks really similar to the last one.
Skilled warriors. You can find great symbolism in much of their architecture.
Yeah, they like pretty things. We get it. Now what, Pete?
It's pretty cool.
Mantis? Any pointers?
It appears the forge goes there. On the altar.
Por qué? But why? Why are we doing this? What's gonna happen? Oh. Can I just put it back in my pocket? I'm Why are we doing this? Like,
seriously?
Nothing happened.
That was anticlimactic.
Something's happening. It spun. It spun.
Much better.
What's happening?
It's not working.
Relic in place. Check.
What's supposed to be working?
Must be something else to it. Hey guys, have a look around. See if you can find anything that looks off.
I am good.
Man, this is gonna be the longest episode ever.
Of course something's wrong, because we're in a freaking Creed temple, where everything is always more complicated than it needs to be. I mean, ain't...
Okay, let's just stop. Okay, it did save just now, so I think we're fine. So I'm just going to stop it there, because this is going to be a long episode if I try to do all that crap. All that reading kind of stressed out a lot more than it should have. But that's fine, that's fine. I can end it there. There's no big deal. So yeah, we made it to the temple, to the shrine. I can't remember what we're doing here exactly, once again. But I guess we'll figure out over time? I don't know. But anyway, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Maybe even ring-a-ling-a-ding that notification bell if you feel like it. And I'll see you next time.